Hi guys, so continuing my series about style icons, today we're gonna talk about Jane Birkin. Jane Birkin is definitely a style icon, so many bloggers again talked about her style. Today I'm gonna maybe cover pretty similar things, but we're also gonna talk about the bone structure of hers and about her type in general. So she was born in 1946 in England, and it's interesting because many people associate her look with more French chic. I think she lived in France, but she was born in UK, so she's actually English. She's an actress and a singer. She started acting in 1965. This is when we start seeing her pictures and seeing her outfits. And 60s was the decade of teenagers protesting against 50s, against parents, against their lack of freedom. So the 60s is the time of the Beatles, and it was English style. It was English music. English band that was very popular, and fashion also, English fashion was very popular in the 60s, and we can see loads of pictures showing London streets in the 60s and how women were dressed at that time and how many parts of the world were trying to repeat what they were doing. And that twiggy dress, small dress, geometric dress was very popular. But let's go back for now for Jane Birkin and her body structure, her body type. We mentioned it a little bit because I have a lot of videos about Kibi types. There are five main types is romantic, dramatic, classic, gamine, and natural. Most of these types have their softer version and sharper version. So overall, we have 13 types. I'm gonna leave the link down below on my Kibi playlist down below if you're interested. But you don't have to watch this to understand this video. It's not about this. If you've seen my previous videos about Sophia Loren, Grace Kelly, Audrey Hepburn, yeah, each one of them has different bone structure, have different body type. If we talk about Jane Birkin, she was another body type. If we talk about Kibi, she's flamboyant natural type. Slightly squarish, blunt bone structure, and at the same time, flamboyant, meaning slightly more on the dramatic side. So he's adding this word flamboyant, showing her extra drama. And where was the drama? In the length. It's not that she was extremely tall. 1 meter 73 centimeters. 5'7", I think, yeah? Did she look tall? Can you perceive her as tall? If you imagine her picture, what is the first thing you perceive? We do perceive that she was tall, not petite, for sure. Was she extremely average, like very classic in shape? No, we don't perceive her as very average, very classic, right? So we definitely can remember her elongated arms and legs. We definitely can remember her elongated face, oblong face, long facial bones. Can we perceive her as very delicate? No. Can we perceive her as very short? No. Can we perceive her as very soft and voluptuous and curvy woman? No. Even though she had a difference between her waist, hips, and there are loads of women that are much curvier than her that are the same type. It's just basically more the bone structure that we're talking about now. And Jane Birkin, we perceive her more as dry and pretty straight. We perceive her slightly on a wider side, but she, again, when we talk about the width can't compensate the height normally. With blunt bones, not sharp, not rounded, but sharp with rounded angles. So if we look at her style in the 60s, that was pretty much 60s, right? So it was pretty much twiggish, but Twiggy had a slightly different type. Twiggy was a type of Audrey Hepburn. She was more like a tomboyish, a teenage body. Her body structure wasn't looking as heavy and as wide and as elongated. She was still slightly elongated, but within her smaller frame. And if we talk about flamboyant naturals, they definitely look slightly bigger and heavier than flamboyant gamines. She's a flamboyant gamine. But it was very trendy to wear that type of dresses, and we can see how women were wearing that very geometric short dresses, showing their huge long legs. And of course it created even more elongation for her body, for her arms and legs. Her arms and legs looked even longer and bigger. She looked bigger as a contrast with those tiny pieces to small dresses. But she was very young in that decade, so it compensated a lot. Maybe if now she would wear that tiny dress like that, probably we would see more contrast with her body. So in the 60s, you can see actually she's still not there with her iconic styles. Her iconic style, I think, will happen a little bit later in the end of the 60s. So when she was just starting out, she was very much in trend. So you could see the eyes. She was making her eyes like Twiggy. Very bright eyes with actually drawn lashes on the bottom and sometimes on top. That very drawn crease without any blending. So all that presented in there, not so much about the lips, and interesting, she had shorter hair, more blunt bob, because bobs and more blunt cuts, again, were very popular in the 60s, because 60s basically is the time of geometry. So everything that was geometric was very popular and trendy at the time. Her smaller bangs, which was cut much more blunt above her brows, more blunt haircut. Maybe she had some layers, but we don't see that layers very much because the cut is very blunt. And then combed hair. Normally also in the 60s, they didn't have the parting of the hair. Sometimes they did, but it was very trendy when they had just one top parting, like one dot here, and from that dot they had all the hair, like the bangs would go forward and then all the rest of the hair would go there and then everything else would go to the back like that. So they didn't have any parting, so they just had one dot in there. So she was also part of it. You can see geometric patterns in there and the dresses. Now, when she met Serge Gainsbourg, French actor, singer, and film director, that was a very famous love story. She started slightly changing her style, and at the end of the 60s, remember we're going slowly to the 70s, she stopped doing that extremely bright eye makeup of the 60s. So she started having whether no makeup or no makeup makeup look or something like this. And her hair, she started growing her hair and her bangs. And I think that this is what happened in the end of the 60s, how she got that very famous hair that nowadays so many fashionistas are trying to repeat. And it's kind of becoming a synonymous to French chic. What happened, I think? So in the 60s, she had that kind of a bob with that fringe. Everything is shorter and more blunt. And then she just let it go. She started just growing it out as it grew to that very long hair and pretty long fringe. And looks like she didn't do much with it, and she stopped doing that back combed hair. She stopped kind of taking care and making like a dressy hair. So I think that is something happened. Something happened in her own world. She relaxed a bit. And I think that her looks at that period of time, the end of the 60s and the beginning of the 70s, and in the 70s and later, her look started to look like after party look, not during the party, not glamorized, dressed, perfect, flawless and stuff. No, after party, as if she had to dress up, but she doesn't care too much. So she looks like that because the time that is after the party is much more interested and fun for her. That was, I think, her style. Later, when she started living in France, I'm not sure when exactly that happened, but closer to the 70s, this is the time when she started having more relaxed and elongated clothes, elongated silhouettes. And of course, if we talk about Jane Birkin, what we remember the most, white shirt, white t-shirt, and jeans, and a straw basket, of course. So she would just take a basket and just carry it everywhere with her, even when she would glam up her look. Then it became very popular and very iconic. That got back on trend, and they started making that straw bags. But she actually had like just a real basket. Just imagine you go now to your thrift shop and buy just a basket for a couple of bucks. Especially that she was pretty tall and she looked tall, so everything big looked pretty cool with her. So in the 60s, again, it was more cropped. Everything was slightly more cropped. Cropped sweaters, pretty small shapes, rounded and high collar neck, very teenage-like, very gamine-ish, I would say. Small skirts, stockings, pretty squarish but compact shoes. So this is basically what was in the 60s, and she was following that style. And geometry and the contrast and color blocks were very popular at that time. You can even see her pose and face in these pictures. Like, we're not used to Jane Birkin like that. We're used to an after party Jane Birkin who is having fun after everything is over and who already has some experience and some tiredness and slightly tired expression on her face. But in the 60s, it was doll-like opened eyes. Eyes of a girl, of a little girl. Eyes of a teenage girl. And that pose, like broken arms and legs, like a naughty student girl. I've seen one picture of her with boyish haircut. Normally, their bone structure is slightly big and squarish. So with this tiny haircuts, normally it just looks like out of proportion slightly. So they look more heavy and angular normally with that type of hair. But again, it depends on many other things too. Of course, the 60s is the Beatles time, so That's her and the Beatles. So now, 70s, her silhouettes of the clothes, the outfits are going closer and closer to the 70s style. We can see flare jeans, very long flare jeans. We can see elongated shirts. So everything elongated looks amazing on them. It doesn't matter if they have waist emphasis or not. They look stunning with no waist emphasis, actually. Again, we can see undone hair, and relaxed silhouettes. So oversized, everything looks stunning on them. She looked very careless. That was the kind of vibe. I'm not gonna dress like my mom in the morning would do curl by curl. I'm not gonna spend time for this. I'm just gonna live my life. I'm not gonna do my hair, I'm not gonna do my makeup, I just go like that, you know? So that was kind of the vibe. It was actually like 60s and 70s protest thing. A lot of the things that she would wear in the 70s and in the 60s you can find in the shops right now. As you know, I made Body Types Wardrobe Pinterest board where you find all 13 types, and Jen Birkin is gonna be under the type called Flamboyant Natural. So I go over thousands of pieces in modern shops right now, in modern trends, cheaper shops or more expensive shops. I just look for as close pieces as I can find that she wore at that time. I can find so many staple pieces, so many basic pieces. And if we talk about Jane Birkin, I was looking for straight blazers, straight oversized jackets, finishing lower on the hips, bigger pants, bigger belts, more relaxed shirts, or you can put the shirt inside of the pants. That type of the body, actually majority of 90s supermodels are also this type, same type as Jane Birkin. All that is relaxed. It doesn't have, they don't have to have this waist emphasis necessarily. They don't lose their elegance and their chic when they don't have that waist emphasis, as opposed to some other types that look slightly more elegant when they have this waist emphasis. That's an interesting thing. So you can see how beautiful that looks, that white relaxed top, white relaxed pants, and that darker jacket on top. It looks extremely modern and very chic, and you can find so many women nowadays making photos in this kind of an outfit, and I think it's beautiful and it's very timeless. The specific of particularly this one for Jane Birkin is that this is oversized and it has that some careless effect about this, and it looks chic. If that was Grace Kelly, she would be lost in this. She can wear same white top, white trousers. The top underneath would probably have less stretchy fabric, probably more stiff, more well-tailored fabric, and then she would put it inside of the pants, and probably the pants would have normal waist or slightly high-waisted, and she would have white trousers again that would keep its shape and would not lie down on the ground, but maybe be a little bit more tailored on the bottom. So those little details, but it can be same look. Jane Birkin's dresses were short or long. Most of them were very simple. They could be just one color, white or black, lace or something. They could be stretchy, could have stretchy material. They were narrow. I've never seen her in something oversized. I've never seen her in a new look dress, for example, with a huge skirt. Everything was very straight. Look at this picture, for example. It's pretty glam dress, right? Loads of sparkles. But look at the bag, look at the makeup, and look at the hair. 60s, 70s kids, they don't care about this. As I said, it's like after party chic. Zero time for preparation. 3 seconds to wear the dress. Okay, let's go. Or for example, a little bit later, she's singing on stage. She's sitting. Yeah, very interesting shoes actually. Pretty color blocked and pretty dressy, I would say. Flare jeans that are ripped at the end, cut at the end. She has bun on her hair. Many of us wake up with this type of hair, but she's on stage. Do you see any makeup? I don't. Maybe she has just a little bit, or maybe she doesn't. It's how she lives her life, and that's how she lives her style. And I'm not showing you or telling you this just to show you that you don't have to take care of yourself, or to glamorize yourself is a bad thing. It's not about this, because we just talked about Grace Kelly, right? We just talked about Sophia Loren. So you can rewatch those videos and just get the idea how each woman beautifies herself. Every woman has her secrets. Every woman has signature look, whether she knows about it or she just doesn't know about it yet. Or this signature look is not formed yet. She feels like she's always trying to find something, but she's still not there. One of the goals of my channel, to get you there, to your personal signature look, so you would find it, you would feel it, and it would just come all together. What I'm trying to show you, that there is no such a formula to success in having that signature look and being always at the glam, being always extremely glamorized. See, so you can achieve huge success waking up with a hair bun and go on stage and sing. You see, so what you feel, that is much more important. how you own it. Sometimes she would wear something provocative. We can see her tits, or it's a very, very long cut at the front of her dress. So it was very provocative. They liked to shock people, especially when she got that duel with Serge Gainsbourg. Once they recorded that very sexual song, and it was forbidden in England, it was very provocative, very, oh my gosh. Wedding dress. No bra. What? I have a wedding today. Okay, give me the dress. 3 minutes. The dress is on. Okay, let's go. If we talk about the coats were very different. They were short or long. Of course, short coats were more 60s style. Or long coats, keeping its shape and pretty classic, looking pretty classic. That type of a bone structure, they look amazing in all those different kinds of coats. Maybe not in the tiny one and with waist emphasis and something and with some frills that would look slightly too smallish for them, but just in general they look amazing with layers, with coats. And besides of those very classic coats, she could also have something very extravagant and very strange, like a zebra coat. We have that stuff right now in the shop, so you can find recently that faux fur coats became so popular and they do so many different things, so you can really be inspired by her and just add something like that to your wardrobe. You can dress it up, you can dress it down, it doesn't matter. It's just that, just feel the vibe of this, that freedom, you know. She could have very classic trenches that are middle size, for example, not super short, not super long, and that is a classic piece, staple piece. You can find it everywhere now, and this is a part of a basic wardrobe. Huge bulky coats also, they look great on that type, on flamboyant naturals, so huge bulky coats normally don't make them look less elegant. If most of the dresses sometimes were very simple and just black and white or white t-shirt and jeans, very, very simple, basic and classic. I also found some pictures of her when she was playing with that bohemian gypsy style, having those huge shapes, unshaped, flowy dresses, very long dresses with huge sleeves, with very interesting colorful patterns, flowers, with loads of necklaces. But if we go back to her classic clothes, I could hardly find her wearing a certain type of a jewelry. Most of the jewelry was actually something that is every shop is now selling. There was basically very small medallions, whether one or two. If you've seen my previous video about Grace Kelly, I was talking about the scarf that she would put instead of a belt for her pants or for her shorts. So maybe Jane Birkin was slightly inspired by Grace Kelly. And it's funny because there's another thing that is connected to Grace Kelly, and it's a bag, Hermes bag. So that famous Birkin bag that they're still selling in the shops, this was named after Jane Birkin. And the story of this bag is very funny because, as I read on the internet, in 1984, Jane Birkin was flying from Paris to London, and she was sitting just next to one of the creators of the Hermes bags, and her bag fell down and much of her stuff just fell out of the bag, and he just mentioned that probably would be better if the bag had some small departments inside so it would be more comfortable to carry stuff inside of that. And she said, Hermes doesn't do bags with departments. And he said, well, I am Hermes. So that was the story. And 1 month later they invited her to their office to discuss a new design of a bag, and then they just called it after her, and then it became a Birkin bag. It's such a great story. And again, if you watched my previous video, you know that Grace Kelly also had a Kelly bag, also Hermes made a Kelly bag for her. If we talk about sweaters, cardigans and turtlenecks, they all look modern right now too. And Jane Birkin also had very regular, actually, sweaters and cardigans. She carried that undone and glamorous look to the 80s. She was already a style icon, so she would just continue to do what she did before. She still was very relaxed, and she would wear sneakers. She would make a picture in dirty sneakers with dirty socks and being pretty undone. She became pretty grungy, I would say. She could mix things that are normally not mixed, like lingerie with a suit, blazer, and with pants. If we talk about shoes, it could be open shoes. Didn't quite see her in high heels, especially in those 50s, very thin high heels, very classic high heels, maybe a couple of times. But normally she would wear boots, like very English boots, sneakers, ballet shoes, Chelsea boots, high 60s boots, sometimes some platform shoes, slightly chunky. They look pretty great with chunkier stuff too. Alright, that's it. I hope you liked the video. Please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel for more videos from this series, and not only. We're gonna talk a lot more about different style icons. I even plan to do review of styles of more modern celebrities, and we're gonna just discuss what type, body type they might have, and we're gonna discuss what kind of outfits and clothes they're wearing and how it looks on them. Stay tuned, I'll see you very soon. Bye-bye. Subscribe on my Pinterest for 13 boards as an inspiration for the body types. Also, you can subscribe on my Instagram. All the links I'm gonna leave down below. Also, you can become my sponsor or subscribe on my Patreon for some exclusive videos, some early access to these videos, and just if you want to support me and my channel. Thank you so much, guys, and I'll see you very soon. Bye-bye.